absurd enlightened master was once among the best commanders. However, he's fallen a little bit behind, but there are still people around that are trying to optimize and still bring this enchantment Esper commander back to his glorious days. Welcome to a deck tech video and an update on how Sur looks today. This deck is brought to us by Big Richie, an organizer from cEDH Nexus, a Discord group that is playing competitive commander over webcam. And as always, in the description below of the video, you can find a link to his decklist. The biggest strength with Sur is the ultra consistency that you only need to put him into play, then attack and find necropotence. He is basically necropotence in the command zone. The three big weaknesses to this deck is that it's first on Esper colors. It's not containing red. Red is starting to really grow as one of the stronger colors in this format. Second, this deck is extremely telegraphed. Everyone knows what you're going to do. You're going to attack with Sur, you're going to find Necropotence, and people can prepare against that once they see Sur on the stack. The third problem is that this deck is requiring a lot of life to function. If you want my personal advice on how to interact and deal with Sur, I highly recommend attacking the player's face. But the scary potential is still there. You could get your Sur into play turn 2, attack on with him turn 3, get your Necro in play with all of your mana untapped. That is really good. So what do we do once we have Necro in play and a bunch of cards in our hand? Once, back in the days, we went for Aetherflux Reservoir Stormwind. However, today, there are other possible solutions with Phasa's Oracle. Back in the days, Shimmer Mirror was a must hit with the Necro. You couldn't win the game if you didn't get your Shimmer Mirror into play with your Aetherflux Reservoir. That has changed. Now, Shimmer Mirror is actually still inside this decklist, and we're gonna talk about why later in the video. However, with Phasa's Oracle as the win con, there are other possible ways to win the game in instant speed. Instead of casting Phasa's Oracle, we are going to reanimate it. And that is why this deck goes by the name of Necro Sur, because we're both playing Necropotence and we're playing Necromancy, an enchantment that you can cast in instant speed. And here's the thing with Necropotence, the rulings that is. Let's actually look at Rest in Peace. Now, Rest in Peace is a replacement effect. If there is a Rest in Peace in play, cards will never actually go to the graveyard. However, with Necropotence, they do go to the graveyard, and then there's a trigger to exile it if you discarded it. However, it is still remaining in the graveyard as long as that trigger is still on the stack, and you can still interact with the card. So, for example, this is what you can do. You go to your discard phase. After Necro, you're probably gonna have more than 7 cards in your hand, so you discard it down to hand size. You're discarding Phasa's Oracle. Then you gain some mana with, let's say, tap a swamp, cast a Dark Ritual, and then you can cast Necromancy in response to the Necropotence trigger before Phasa's Oracle gets exiled. Ta-da! You now have Phasa's Oracle in play, and now you can cast Tainted Pact or Demonic Consultation, also in instant speed, in response to the Phasa's Oracle ETB trigger. Having Phasa's Oracle as the win con instead of Aetherflux Reservoir just increases the chance that the Necro hit will perform some form of win. But this is also the reason why Big Richie is still playing Shimmer Mirror inside this deck, because it increases the capabilities for the win con. For example, you could cast a Wishclaw Talisman in instant speed because of the Shimmer Mirror. And sometimes you need to color fix a little bit better. For example, it's really easy to gain some black mana with instant speed Cabal Ritual and instant speed Dark Ritual, but you don't get white or blue mana. Sometimes you really want to have that silence effect before you start to combo off. And sometimes you need to cast a Vampiric Tutor to tutor up a combo piece, and then you need to cast a Brainstorm that is requiring blue mana to draw that card. And Shimmer Mirror helps out here, being able to cast artifacts that can produce blue and white mana. But there's one more instant speed reanimation spell you just have to know about, Shallow Grave. The cool thing about this spell is it also grants haste. Sure, you have to sacrifice the creature afterwards, but we don't really care. The cool thing about this is that if your Sur gets killed with a red elemental blast or, well, anything of the sort, which usually happens, I mean, people are usually killing Sur, that is the correct play against Sur, kill Sur. Well, with Shallow Grave, you can reanimate Sur for only 2 mana and then on the same turn attack with him. And Necromancy is also great for backup here, as you can basically pay 3 mana for a Surf from your graveyard. That is fine. So Necromancy and Shallow Grave both help out in getting to the combo, but also finalizing and winning with the combo. When you're building this deck, don't forget the core cards. You'd really want to have a Grasp of Fate. That's great if the game is a little bit stacked out and you need to remove stacks pieces and want to interact with your Sir, because you can't win with Necro at the moment. Also, highly recommend Yuled Lotus. That is a great upgrade, even though it only produces 2 mana, as it is 1 generic and 1 colored mana for you, because you need 3 different colors. It's still helping you get your Sir into play as fast as you can, and that is the core game plan here. Get Sir into play as fast as you can. Another possible upgrade here is Peer into the Abyss, a great new card. One of the big problems with Sir is that people are attacking you. You might go down to, let's say, 10 life. From here, you can't really win the game with Ad Nauseam, nor can you win the game with Necropotence. However, if you cast Peer into the Abyss, you'll only lose half of the 10 life going down to 5, but you still draw half of your entire deck. It's a little bit risky having Peer into the Abyss if you're going to play Ad Nauseam, which you probably should, because Ad Nauseam is great, probably stronger than Peer into the Abyss. Also, you might consider having Dark Confidant inside this deck, so Peer into the Abyss is something to consider, but it's not an out to include. Hull Breacher is also a new upgrade for Sir, or upgrade for Blue in general. However, Blue, or well, Esper, is lacking wheels. Red has more capabilities of wheels, so the only thing that you have is Windfall and Time Twister. And you could definitely include Hull Breacher inside the stick because of this, but your consistency of having a Hull Breacher wheel is a little bit lower because you're lacking red. What about Opposition Agent, a new black control card? Now, it is a great card, but it's not auto-included. You see, this is a fast turbo combo deck. You don't really want to have control cards in general. Now, sure, you could include it depending on your playstyle and your own personal metagame, but you want to go fast. You want a Ritual Sir into play, you want to pay a lot of life with your Necro, you want to get a lot of rituals, fast mana and tutors, and some interaction, so Opposition Agent doesn't really fit into the primary game plan here, but it's definitely a card you could consider. In general, when you're trying to go for the Necro Storm run, there are 3 things that could make you brick. Fizzle, so to say. You don't get the fast mana that you need, so you can ritual out and cast spells you need in instant speed, or you don't get the specific combo pieces nor any form of tutors for your combo pieces, or you don't get any form of interaction versus your opponents, because you haven't really casted Necropotence. You have put it into play with Sir. This means that your opponents could be sitting there with interaction counterspells in their hand that they could use against you, so you might need some instant speed counterspells, preferably Force of Will or similar of the sort, that you can cast without paying mana. And your deck really need to max out on these 3 parts. Lots of fast mana, lots of instant speed, free to cast or low CMC cost interaction, and a lot of instant speed tutors. And this is where cards like Hull Breacher and Oppo Agent doesn't help out. They are great cards and you could definitely play them for other reasons, but they don't help with your game plan. If you wanna see this deck in some battle action, we have a gameplay uploaded on this YouTube channel with the boss himself, Big Richie, piloting this Sir deck. You can find the link in the top right corner of the video monitor or in the description below of the video. That's it for me for today, and good luck with building your Sir deck.
Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video. If you like what I do and you wanna support me, feel free to share my videos or even checking out my Patreon page. Also, purchasing cards from the TCG Players website using the affiliate link in the description below of the video will also help the channel grow. So a big thank you to all of you.